Every time your heart beats, your arteries carry about a quarter of the blood to your brain. Why does an organ that takes up 2% of your body weight require 25% of your blood? A piece of brain tissue the size of a grain of sand has about 100,000 neurons within it. It may be small, but it's really, really dense, and it needs a lot of nutrients to function. But where do we get those nutrients from? You guessed it, from food. Given that our brains rely so heavily on our diet, what happens when that diet is filled with fat and sugar? I couldn't just explore how junk food could be killing us from a sofa. Instead, my girlfriend Halle and I went to her home and the home of all things ultra-processed, America.
US and A, greatest country in the world.
This process has made me more concerned than ever about junk food. Not only is it destroying our neurons, but junk food is designed to appeal to our most primitive drives. Drives that we don't have any control over whatsoever. The first step to overcoming these issues is to understand them. And to do that, we first need to understand what junk food is.
You need more than heat, boy, according to Hoyle. You need popcorn, salt, butter and oil in a frying pan, or to be completely proper, you ought to have a popper.
Junk food is high in a couple of delicious ingredients, saturated fat and sugar. The delicious duo. It's not just that though, there's another key step in this process that's detrimental for your brain. Let's take the beloved McDonald's french fries. They start as a mineral-dense potato straight out of the ground, dense with potassium, iron and zinc. They then get put through this 12-step process to become french fries. But through that process, their healthy components are replaced by oil and fat to give them that extra crunch and make them last a bit longer. By the end of that process, there's basically no nutrients left. The way that fast food companies appeal to our subconscious drives isn't far off voodoo. So where better to explore that than New Orleans? This is me eating a beignet in Cafe du Monde. I decided to take a massive bite for the camera and instantly regretted it when I nearly choked first of all and then coughed up a load of icing sugar. So I forgave it for trying to murder me because it was absolutely delicious. And then the next day we couldn't help but get another. We were fully addicted to beignets and got them every single day while we were in New Orleans. Junk food appeals to the most primitive parts of your brain, and scientists have shown just how addictive they are. You might think that it's the delicious taste of junk food that makes us want it more. Without that incredible taste, we'd be just completely disinterested, right? Wrong. In a study, researchers numbed the subjects' taste and blindfolded them. They went on to feed them sugary and savory foods. When the researchers asked them which food they would like more of, with no taste in sight, surely we'd expect them to choose completely randomly and the distribution between the two to be pretty even. But that wasn't the case. The subjects craved more of the sugary foods, showing us that our cravings aren't just driven by taste, but by something else entirely. Irrespective of the taste, the sugar from those beignets was signaling my dopamine reward pathway to tell me to seek out more of those balls of sugary delight. This was a big deal when I realized it because I thought it was just the taste that was driving us to crave junk food. But now I realized that without the taste, we'd still want more of it. Sugar appeals to our most primitive drives. Now, you might be wondering what all this talk about sugary cravings has to do with daily stress levels. Well, it turns out that there's a deeper connection than we might realize. While indulging in those sugary treats might provide instant gratification, the aftermath could be more than just a sugar crash. Research suggests that our dietary choices, particularly those high in sugar, can influence our body's stress response. So, while I was busy satisfying my sweet tooth in New Orleans, I couldn't help notice how my sugar intake seemed to be impacting my overall mood and stress levels. As we walked down Bourbon Street, surrounded by vibrant sounds and beautiful sights, I couldn't shake off this feeling of unease. Halle managed to work out that there was some potential like tourist scams on the street, and we managed to get away from them. But I could feel the signs of stress creeping in. It was when we finally stepped away from the crowds that I noticed my belly rumbling and I was absolutely starving. Not for like fruits or salads, but for something far more buttery, and I wouldn't settle for anything less than 1,000 calories.
Oh, that was good.
Why do we crave these sweet treats when our stress response kicks in? When you're under stress, cortisol is released, and cortisol increases your blood sugar to provide your muscles with the energy they need to fight or run away, and also to provide your brain with the food it needs to think of creative solutions. The spike in blood sugar provides fuel to all of those cells in your brain and body, but it leaves you craving foods high in sugar to replenish those energy stores. There's more though. Your body wants a quick way to feel better as well, and a Dunkin' Donut can be a great way to soothe or distract yourself during times of stress. It does that through serotonin. That donut will signal the release of serotonin, your feel-good hormone, triggering temporary relief from your stressful situation. While it can soothe you in the moment, junk food can be detrimental in the long term. Firstly, through causing you to have a larger stress response to future events through massive cortisol releases. And inflammation and nutrients also play a role there too, but I'll be covering that later on. What I'm getting at here is that food and emotion are so closely linked. Your emotion drives you to eat, and your eating alters how you're feeling. I personally find that during times feeling stressed or low, I opt for the most unhealthy food I can possibly find. The neurotransmitter changes, emotional reaction to the taste, and subconscious drive to crave sugar are all leading to those choices. But those choices don't come without consequences. These foods could permanently impact your memory and focus, impacting more than just your waistline. So, to explore these effects, we need to leave New Orleans and head to Steel City. After our adventures in New Orleans, we took a flight to Halle's hometown, Pittsburgh. She showed me the beautiful views, introduced me to her family, and then told me I'd been missing out for my whole life. Why? Because I'd never been to Primanti Brothers. I can't argue with her. She was absolutely right. I'd been missing out, and their signature sandwich was absolutely unreal. But after, I couldn't stop myself from craving more. I wanted coffee and cake, despite being so bloated that I had to undo my belt. While we were eating more, I couldn't help but jumble up my words, and my ability to tell any sort of story was absolutely shocking. So why is it that my brain stops working after these massive meals, and I can't help but also crave more at the same time? A study took 110 healthy people and had them switch to a Western diet for a week. 2 Belgian waffles for breakfast on 4 of the days, and 2 takeaways through the week as well. The people had big issues with learning and memory when they switched to that diet. The scientists put that down to this bit of their brain, their hippocampus. Its main roles are around memory, regulating emotions, and appetite. As you replace healthy foods with junk foods, you get far less essential nutrients that you need for your brain to work. Nutrients like B vitamins, vitamin C, vitamin E, and omega-3 fatty acids. The shift in food choice can alter the balance of gut bacteria, known as the gut microbiome, and trigger inflammation throughout your body, including in your hippocampus. And that's why it's having such a big impact on my ability to tell stories, to think, and just to really impact my brain processes. I really do believe that we can have everything in moderation. I'm still going to eat junk food, but keeping its impacts on my brain, mood, and stress response in mind. So now you understand how junk food is impacting your brain. You might want to put down your burger and try running instead. So check out how running positively impacts your brain in this video.